if you're a person of color, if you're poor, and if you speak English as a second language, you're 20 times less likely to be in gifted education. 20 times less likely to receive gifted education services. Gifted education is talent development, and my work focuses on empowering teachers to design learning environments that nurture and develop the talents of all children. Why is this so important? In the state of Washington, children are mandated to be identified as gifted as early as kindergarten. Access and equity start right here in kindergarten, in learning environments that allow students to demonstrate and show and share their talents. These children are in Jamila's class, and they're measuring the temperature of their drinking water. In an investigation of hot and cold, they're very curious. How cold is the principal's air-conditioned office in compared to our hot classroom in Illinois in August? And they're going outside and they're measuring the temperature. And they're coming into the cafeteria, measuring the temperature in the freezer and the food. These children have been involved in project investigations. Prior to me meeting Jamila, she was doing a unit on apples. And all of the children made applemen at her art center. The applemen consisted of pre-cut apples. A little apple for the head, big apple for the body, little teeny tiny apples for the feet and the hands, and little accordion-shaped paper to be the hands and the legs. At the end of Jamila's unit, she had a wall of all applemen, and they all looked alike. When we began working together, the next year we did the unit differently. The children came up with questions. How tall are apple trees? Where do apples grow? What's the difference between green apples and red apples? And where are the seeds, and how many are there? So we took the students to the orchard. The students drew observational drawings. They came into their classrooms. They began to make predictions. Jamila saw her students differently. They were engaged. She saw the differences in their thinking. Jamila realized that if she did these kinds of activities, she would see differences and the strengths and the talents in the way children were thinking. The learning environments that we need to design for young children need to be ones where children can create their own ideas and answer their own questions. They need to be aesthetically beautiful and inviting for students to have opportunities to go their own direction and pursue answers to their own questions. In order to nurture and develop talents, learning environments have to invite those children so teachers can see them clearly. My work recently in the state of Washington has been working to design professional development modules to train teachers all across the state to how to identify the talents and strengths of children differently so that all children will be included in talent development, and especially those students of color, those students who are poor, and those students who speak a second language. Who's got talent? All children have talent. Thank you.